Okay, now it's 12:55 and we're about to head off to KKH for appointment with Dr. Ho. How do you feel?
Good. Been preparing for this day for a while. Been having some off and on contractions the past couple of weeks actually, but they always go away. So definitely think I'm in some sort of early labor, but actual labor I don't think so yet. So I'm gonna get in, get induced, get the actual labor going, and hopefully Mei slips out real fast and real easy, cause second time round should be a lot more bearable.
Do you feel prepared? Do you feel like it's too early or...
Interestingly, I actually do feel prepared. I think the last couple of weeks of HL really frees up our like time to prepare logistically and mentally also for baby's arrival. So it's really nice that she took her time. Like she gave us that space to prepare. And yeah, like it's really good timing, I think.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah, we're gonna go get a cab and like wait for Dr. Ho outside her clinic, so...
Okay, let's go. So right now it's about 1:50. We have just arrived at KKH. And Cheryl has done some tests.
Yeah, so did some urine and blood tests. No, urine and blood pressure tests. And yeah, I don't know, like not much different from past few weeks, so... Waiting to see the doctor now. Yeah, hoping that I'm at least 3 cm dilated so I can like go break water back. Haha. Oh, that's blood pressure though.
Oh, okay. Go, mama.
Hi, alright, we're waiting for the admissions counter now. So what happened was we went to see Dr. Ho, told her that pretty much same symptoms as last week, a bit more contractions off and on, but they always go away. So yeah, just more white discharge. Then she says like, okay, let's check you. And then like baby's still head down, baby's head is facing up, she looks very pretty. And doctor says that baby has dropped to the pelvis. Don't know what that means actually. Then she checked that I'm 1 to 1.5 cm dilated. That what else? That yeah, good lah, good, shows progress from last week, because last week was 0 cm. Then she said like, oh, we can either get admitted today, like tonight or tomorrow 6 p.m. Then we're like, oh, like today will be better. And then she said, oh, okay, then today 6 p.m. is fine too. So like, yeah, we like they'll do the pill and then they'll do the break water bag and then like oxytocin. So be prepared to meet her maybe like tonight or tomorrow morning. Then we're like, oh my god, that's so soon.
Okay, we're in the ward now for induction. Thoughts?
It's 4:20 p.m. We just checked in. It was like such a breeze, like just understanding the payment and all that. And then like, yeah, now we're waiting for the induction. So just a pill and yeah.
Time check. 6:52. The pill thingy is done. What do you call it?
Pill thingy has dissolved, I guess.
Pill thingy has dissolved. And now it's food. Kind of looks bad.
Healthy food. Healthy food.
Okay, now it's 8:30. We just moved to A ward.
Yay!
And what else happened? In between. Actually, I don't remember when...
Plant and zombies on the iPad. I was meant to view how to take care of a, like, newborn and stuff. Ugh.
Yeah, I cleared a couple of levels. It was pretty fun.
Then...
I should download it when I get
like, it. Like, randomly, like, three nurses came rushing in saying that, like, there's antibodies in my blood and they need to take more blood. And, like, I'm, like, confused AF. Like, what's this got to do with the delivery? And then, like... Okay, anyway, so like they tried to take my blood, but like apparently like I'm full term and like my blood vessels are very small now, so like they can't draw any blood, so they had to get a doctor to come in and take the blood. It's so weird. I don't understand what's going on.
From your wrist, Ingrid?
Yeah, from my freaking wrist. Which the nurse said that it never ever happens, except only when a doctor does it.
Ooh.
Ooh. You were just playing Plant and Zombies, you didn't even know what was going on. Anyway, it's not as painful as compared to like the throbbing pain from the IV drip. It's freaking horrible. I feel like this is more painful than childbirth. Like, I'm pretty sure I said it for Jet's childbirth also, that like the IV drip was honestly like way more like of an issue rather than the actual delivery. Okay, anyway, so we were just talking about how like so far we find this like labor more bearable compared to Jet's one for some reason. I think cause like we were quite well rested when we checked in, right?
Yep. And in other news, we got ward A again, so I don't have to sleep at a car park. Oh, or lobby.
I thought you just said that.
Oh.
But yes, by an A ward, which is like, yay, apparently subject availability one, not necessarily you want that you can get. Yeah. So, yeah, what's the game plan? From now, 8:30 to 10, we're supposed to just walk around and do some squats. Then 10, they're going to bring us to the delivery ward, because like by 11, they want to break water back, I guess, if I'm 3CM. Hopefully I am. I don't know why, but like the doctors and nurses seem really confident that since it's my second time, I should be dilating relatively fast. Yeah, so hopefully it happens, lor.
I think it's because your first induction was successful. So,
oh yes, yes, Dr. Ho did say that.
Pretty confident that the second time will go.
Yeah, so
well.
Yeah, I guess the body really knows what to do. But the funny thing is, although I do feel like my tummy tightening and all that, I wouldn't really call it contractions still. I don't know, like it's so weird. Like is it because like I've been through like what is like actual like 8 cm kind of contractions, then I know that what I'm going through now is relatively nothing, so I don't consider it as real contractions or what. But anywho, it's still very bearable lah. I'm still walking around talking and stuff, but yeah, just hoping that things progress. And yeah, can't wait to meet Cass, man. Anything to say?
No.
We got a free mindfulness app, cause like we were asked if we wanted to take part in this like postpartum survey, and it's like freaking on point for me, cause it's about listening to music and meditation, like to get through postpartum blues. And they gave me a free subscription to the Expectful. Is it Expectful? Let me see. Yeah, Expectful app. Wow, which I've wanted for like so long. And like a $20 Apple iTunes card. Yay! Yeah. Okay. Ciao.
So now it's 10 o'clock and we were sort of taking the heartbeat and contractions and stuff, and I think Cass was a bit excited, like too excited. Her heartbeat was like really high. 170, 180 for quite a while. I think she was really too excited, so nurses were a bit concerned. Hopefully it's just false alarm and yeah, she's just a bit nervous.
Yeah, no, but I feel like we both feel great when we're not lying down, so like I think, I don't know, just like not the right time, I guess. Maybe it's too soon. Yeah, but I think I feel better after I stand down and walk for a bit.
She calmed down already.
Feels like, yeah.
Okay. Cool. She's still like kicking. You said she was hiccuping, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Pretty sure she's fine. Just don't want to go now.
Okay. But yeah, I think we're probably gonna go in soon.
Yeah. Oh man.
To the delivery ward.
Yeah, rush it off. Should we have waited?
I don't think so.
Okay, like, we've come this far, right?
Yeah.
We felt peace, right, going into it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Traces of blood.
I don't know.
I don't. Okay, time check. 11:21. We are finally at the delivery ward. Baby seems to have calmed down a little. Yeah. Now it's 160-ish as compared to 180 just now.
160, yeah.
Now it's 16 plus, yeah.
I remember like 16 plus was okay, if I'm not wrong. Let me check up the white. 163,
yeah.
Yeah. Well, my butt is so itchy. My vagina is so itchy. Later I'll go to the toilet. Clean.
After the CTG. Yeah. Okay. Check in again.
Saline helps,
Yeah. Probably saline was.
Oh, I don't even have a delivery ward now. Did we say that already? Huh?
Yeah, I said that already. You said your butt was itchy.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And then we will... Time now is 11:22. I don't know, I guess it's 28 September maybe then. Just hoping for like a relatively smooth and fast delivery. Can't wait for epidural. Although I'm not really feeling any contractions yet. So weird, right?
Yeah.
Maybe I should just like chill. Did the graph show any contractions?
No, I don't think so. Not much.
Oh my god, it's so funny. But I guess like the water bag breaking will trigger it lah.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, but just don't know whether maybe it's ready for water bag breaking.
Yeah, I guess we just got to trust
it. She's okay now, Like, just now she was fucking angry.
Probably the way you're lying down.
Yeah, and then now she's damn chill. And I'm kind of on my back again. I think we should just like the stuff just now. Especially the end of shift where you can like...
Like, very obvious that she... Yeah. Okay, yay. Mei finally have calmed down. Now her heart beats around 150. Down from around 170, 180. So I think she's in a much better spot right now. From what we can see.
That's really heartening.
What?
That's really heartening. 150, yeah. 150.
150. Thereabouts.
Oh.
On average.
I guess the saline helps, or like, I don't know, waiting it out a bit helps.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, she just needed a bit more time, and I think the saline really helped
her. I think she just needed a bit of time. Like, it just probably caught her at a bad time, like, when she was, like, kind of still, like, funking it out with the pill stuff. And I think it helps that, like, the water bag hasn't broken, so, like, she can still, like, you know, swim and stuff at her own time. Then, oh my god, I'm just feeling so freaking itchy at my butt and my vagina. I don't know why. Ugh. It's so weird. And like, the interesting thing is, I still don't feel any pain. Like,
oh yeah, zero contractions.
I don't feel any contractions, which is, I don't know if it's good or bad, but like, the midwife said, honestly, like, some people at this stage, they just take the epidural anyway, so they don't feel anything at all, which I thought was quite interesting. I'll see how it goes, I guess. Yeah. Did maybe swim away? She did, right?
But the...
I feel her swimming away. Okay. 150.
Mm.
15 what?
151.
Wow, so low already. Yay. When can I go and wash my... The laughing just sent me to heaven immediately.
Okay, now it's 12:30, right? The water bag just broke. Good news, there wasn't any poop, So far, so good. It's just that heartbeat is a bit high, so they need to monitor much longer, or at least for a while longer, just to make sure everything's fine.
Before I can get epidural.
Yeah.
I guess, I already know I want epidural, so I'm not taking it, right?
Yeah, I think you should.
Yeah, I think it'll help with dilation also. Wow, but the gush of warmth was like, oof. Was that more gross than the pee?
Not really. I think I'm okay with it. You heard her say, right? Are you okay? Doctor,
tell me. Oh, yeah.
I'm alright with seeing this.
Was it like they were okay, right? Burning, eh?
What's burning?
The itch is burning. It's so itchy. I'm feeling way more troubled by the itch than the contractions. My vagina is itchy as fuck.
Is it burning?
Buddy. Help.
Hey, it's another check-in at 2 a.m. So we just put in the epidural. Contractions are starting to come. Pain score 3-4. I think Cheryl's not really in the mood to talk. And... probably try to catch some sleep before the actual pushing.
Enjoy your epidural for a while, okay? Then later I insert, huh? Okay.
the audio vlog. It's now 2:38. Dr. Ho just came to check 3 cm still. Baby's head down but facing daddy. Don't know what that means. So she got me to lie on my side. Very, very comfortable with the epidural. Daddy's also sleeping. Contractions are 1 minute apart, which is very encouraging, I think. Yeah. The midwives here all listen to Taylor Swift. So that's great. Gonna try and catch some sleep now. Ciao.
Hey, right now it's roughly about 4:15 a.m. 4:20 a.m.
This is the time that Kes always wakes up at night.
When yeah. Soon. And you're about
4 to 5 cm
dilated. I think it took a while though from
Yeah, it did.
3 to 5.
I think we slept from like 2:30 to 3:30. Then like then what ? I also don't know. Just monitoring Kes.
Yeah, I think just monitoring in general, and thank God everything is going well. The heartbeat stabilized at 130, 140, and the contractions are very regular.
Is it? You can see
Yeah, I can see the humps.
High,
I don't know if it's high, I can't tell, but I can see consistent humps.
Mm.
Yeah, like they're very regular and at the same like intervals and
I think
peaks.
When the cervix like softens out, it'll immediately be like a lot like wider also. But anyway, it's just really interesting because like I thought that the second labor would be like lightning speed, but no, it's still like crawling, but it's fine.
Yeah.
What matters most is that they come at their own time lah.
Yeah, they really take their time.
They take their freaking time, man. Kes and Jet.
Really much faster than the first round already lah.
Jet like also max out the 24 hour, then he also max out the 12 hour, then like he took his time.
Yeah.
Then but I think this time definitely thankful that like the induction didn't like stress out Kes.
Yeah. What time did the water bag break?
I can't remember. 12 or 1.
12 or 1. So hopefully you can see her off site in a couple more hours.
Yeah.
Mm. What's the time now, Cheryl? Roughly around 7:05. How are you feeling?
Around 6 past 6:15, I think, or 6:30. Doctor came to check. 6 cm dilated.
Yeah.
I mean, it's progress for sure. Like, it's not stagnating. Just it's really slow compared to Jet, I guess. When I don't know.
Yeah, she's just really cozy.
Yeah, she's very cozy. Oh gosh. I don't know. Like, I think both my kids like to stay inside for very long. I'm feeling a bit woozy. Just continuing to rest, I guess. Hopefully from now till 10, it can get exponentially faster. I don't know. But anyway, I think everybody was sleeping lah. Daddy, mommy, and Kes, so.
You still got some rest.
There wasn't much action, I think. Yeah. Hi.
Now
10 cm dilated.
8:30 and 10 cm dilated.
That's fucking painful. Can't talk.
Okay. But I think we're almost there. Just need a bit more time for the baby to. For the baby's head to go lower in the pelvis, I think. And then probably about time to push surgery. Just waiting for a doctor to come by. Check in again. So baby Kizzy is here. She's healthy. Everything went smoothly. Doctor said everything went well.
9:17 a.m.
Oh. Yeah.
I pushed like how many times?
Like, honestly, for only like 10 to 15 minutes max.
Yeah.
It was like, for Jet it was an hour. Yeah. For her it was like 15 minutes max. So it was very fast.
Mm, she looks like Jet.
Yeah, she looks like Jet. Hi.
So you saw the placenta and everything?
I saw everything. So Dr. Ho. Like trying to loosen, quote unquote, loosen your vagina to sort of let her through, because like it's all the skin and flesh, right? So she was pushing through while you're having contractions and pushing at the same time. And then, yeah, I saw everything actually. Like, even before we started pushing, she was like, oh, do you want to see? You can already see her head. Like, she's already coming out, like, probably 3 or 4 pushes, and she'll be out already. So she showed me, like, her head, and I could see it. Like, her hair and her
skull. Okay, so backtrack a bit. It was 6 cm at what time?
7, I think.
7 cm at, I can't remember. Oops.
Yeah, but by the time it was 9, it was already 10. No, actually 8:30, it was 10 cm.
Oh,
yes. Then we waited for an
because
hour.
I complained about like very bad pain, right?
Yeah, I think that's when it started.
And that's when they went to check and they're like, oh, okay, so you're 10 cm.
Yeah. And she's like, so heavy, so much heavier than Jet, but she looks exactly like Jet.
Then I cried.
It's very cool. Don't scratch. Don't scratch.
Great pain. We finally reached 10 cm.
Yeah.
Guess don't scratch. You're scratching yourself.
Okay, now it's 1 p.m. and we're back in the ward.
My vagina is on fire.
Your vagina is what?
On fire.
Nice. Yeah, I think now we're just resting, waiting for baby Cass to come by our room again, then we can start breastfeeding. I think she's just running a couple of tests. And yeah, doing some vaccinations.
She's just
and
resting
stuff.
Already lah from now on.
Yeah, yeah.
Recovery, making sure I can pee and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome. I guess we'll do an after action review later on where Cheryl will have lots to complain about the service or like epidural or whatever.
The fetal heart rate and shit.
Yeah.
That's true.